Hey guys, just had to put a fresh battery in that GoPro. It finally went dead. I've had it running for so long. Anyway, I totally was not going to make a video today, but just a few things to mention. Try and make this quick, like always. Loving my front end. I say that every day, and it's true. And I'm very happy with what I did there. One thing to talk, my shift knob arrived today. Unfortunately, it came signature only, and of course, I'm not home because I have a normal life. So I'll try and go get that tomorrow, and I'll have a shift knob video pretty soon. Something else crossed my mind, and then I got something else that's more important. See this mirror? It's tight. Now come look at my driver's one. I think it's always been like this, just an FYI. This one has a movement, and obviously this is some kind of cam thing, you know, where it just snaps into little bumps. And apparently my outer one just has movement in it. Not that big a deal. I don't see it vibrating or anything. Just a comment that it isn't tight like my other one. Something else, I'm not really concerned about it, but just want to mention it because I have read this in forums before. All of a sudden recently, I have a timing tension or rattle on startup. And this is somewhat normal. I wouldn't say it's common, but I've definitely read about a lot of people having it. A lot of people think it's like your engine and stuff. I don't think it is. And I can't show you right now because the car isn't cold. But on the cold start mornings now, I hear a rattle for 2-3 seconds when I start it. It's so mechanically light and loose. I know it's the tensioner filling up with oil, you know, and tightening up. It's not the oil filter's OEM. It's all good quality. It isn't like I have a crappy oil filter leaking out the pressure. So it's just strange that my tensioner all of a sudden at 12,000 miles just started not really retaining its oil quite as well to keep it nice and tensioned. Goes away in a few seconds, never hear it again till it's cold. Just something to bring up in case anybody else has that issue and just something to think about. Let me think what else I wanted to talk about. Be right back. Oh, my tunes. Well, I've been posting a lot of that on Facebook, but you know I'm working on that new Torque Performance Stage 2 tune, version 300, maybe version 301, but I think it's based on 300. You only need 301 if you run a cob off the shelf, which I do not. So let's just say it's based on 300. I started on Rev 11. I have Rev 19 on the car right now. I have not had a chance to log this yet. I'm just too busy. The only time I can log is late at night, and unfortunately I don't get a second map quick enough at night to log twice. So I'm just doing basically one rev a day. It started out good. Rev 12, my second rev of this test, was a strongest stage 2 I've ever felt. I talked about it somewhere or other. And the car was too fast. It had a lot of knock, but it was just a rocket. It was really fun for like a few hours while I got to run that map. And then it kind of went downhill for a while. My 13, 14, 15, 16, 17 were all kind of so-so. They all had 141 knock. A couple of them had 282 knock. Not at the top, but mid-range type of stuff. And so the last two, let's see, 18. 18 got a little better. It was really strong. 18 was when I got my Rev 12 power back. It really felt killer again, and I loved it. Unfortunately, I logged it, and I did get... hell was that? And I did get a 141. Oh, that's just a barbecue foil tray, foil drip tray. I got a 141 at the Rev 18 at red line area 6000. That wasn't that great. So he made more tweaks to the 19 here, and I'm gonna test it tonight, see if he can get rid of that 6000 141. It's almost totally safe. I mean, a 141 is very minor. But still, I don't really like it at redline. I like a perfect map, as you know. I can always go back to my Rev 10, which was before this Recall 2 maps that I'm working on, which was perfect if I need to. But I am sensing a little more power eking out of this version 300. But I'm also noticing it's a lot more work. It's a lot more complicated to tune, at least for my tuner, right at this moment, because it's kind of a new thing, you know. Everybody has to learn the new stuff. And it's seeming to take a little bit longer to get that knock removed, but I do feel more power than my non-version 300 maps, honestly. It just feels better and stronger in all areas, but the knock is the concern. I don't want a better, stronger map if it's going to have knock as a consequence, you know. I'd rather have a clean map that I cannot worry about and sacrifice a little power. The last thing I was going to talk about, I was thinking about doing some black tips, but then I thought, well, it kind of, the little bit of chrome kind of just goes with the little bit of chrome here on my badge. If I do the tips black, you know, then there's still chrome left and it's getting too picky. Plus, I mean, the whole problem of trying to, it's getting windy, I'm talking close, trying to paint it or do, how the hell would I get the tips black? I really wanted some slide over little covers in black, like black aluminum. I've never found any. If anybody has any clues, just a perfect black cover with a rolled tip on the end that you could slide right over the stock tip and it would just tuck around the edge. You know, a perfect solution basically, which I don't think exists. I've never ever seen that. I've been searching for a year for black tips for this car. And now that I'm running out of stuff to do, that's coming to the surface again to complete my whole look, the whole black look. So if anybody has tips on the black, I'm definitely not going to be cutting off my tips, welding new ones, nothing like that. I just leave it alone if that's the case. So that's what I've got going right now. All I have on order is one replacement bolt for the under tray that I made a video on a few versions ago where I sheared one bolt and got real lucky on that. Nothing else in order right now that I can think of. Oh, remember my steering wheel emblem? I just had a comment in my YouTube, an old video, probably one of my red ones, where I made a video and I talked about how it's flat and it doesn't come up to the edges, remember? I guess the actual maker of the badges saw that video or comment and he said he actually fixed it and made it so it curls up at the edges to be a better fit. And he's sending me some sets free to go, I mean, one set free, just as a thank you for kind of pointing out the flaws and stuff. So, and I told him I did want those in white. I mean, I don't really need one right now, but if I was going to put another, I'd probably go with white again. I'm just kind of digging the white look. The interior is pretty much done. Besides the shift knob I have coming, real psyched about that. I have a stock bezel coming to put back. Long story, but I probably mentioned it before. I just got tired of the black everywhere look. I like a little bit of sparkle. So I do have a stock bezel coming back. Then I'll probably sell that Subi matte thing because no sense in keeping it. Oh, one thing I did, I forgot. I took a lot of time to paint this Cobb cover. This is the stock gray cover. A lot of time, I mean like two or three attempts at a paint job, stripping the paint off, even did wet sand, and it's a really hard surface to paint. See, I mean, this is that after sanding and perfect paint job, and it's still just, it's a really hard surface for some reason to paint really nicely. So I just went with the black. I love it like when it's a little bit dark, when you can't see all the flaws, like in your car at night. It just really looks cooler to me, I think, than just a gray one. This is just all one color, all black. Just wanted to show you that. That's all I got for now. This video was too long already. I'll see you next time.